You know when people are trying to be innovative during COVID, and that's what these remind me of.
It's a little different. Oh, but I'm not mad.
Have a busy day ahead. I have two events today, back to back, in the same place, which is good. I'm a little worried because I'm going to be out for about 6 hours and I'm going to have on heels, so that concerns me. But I am going to the Burberry, invited me to their spring summer 2024 presentation at Lenox Mall, so I'm going to that. And then right after that, I'm going to another Ferrari event, which is right across from Burberry. So that's nice that they're right across from each other. I'm excited because I was like stagnant for a minute, like not leaving the house. And now that the weather is good, like I'm just glad to be out of the house, getting dressed up, going to events. I'm super excited that I get a chance to experience these luxury events because that doesn't happen very often. So every time I get invited, I'm like, me? You want to invite little old me to a fashion event, to a Burberry event? Like, who am I? So that always gets me super excited. I attempted to steam my skirt. I don't know, the steamer wasn't liking it. So then I tried to iron it on like low heat. Hopefully it looks good, but we'll see. I have been enjoying making my own yogurt parfaits in the morning. Super, super good. And I started because I'm pescatarian and sometimes I eat meat, fish, sometimes I don't. So I'm trying to find ways to incorporate protein into my diet, and yogurt seems to be the best way to go. I use this brand, I guess it's pronounced Oikos, and they have 15 grams of protein, zero artificial sweeteners, 0 grams of added sugar. So it's pretty good. It's so funny because I don't like vanilla at all, but by the time I add strawberries and honey and granola and cinnamon, like, it tastes really good. So I have been enjoying my little yogurt parfaits in the morning. That's what I have been eating, and I'm enjoying it. All right, so I finished my makeup. I didn't vlog the makeup process because... Sorry, that was the train going by. But I didn't vlog my makeup process because I was running a little late. I had to run to Best Buy to get a new SD card because my SD card was full and I wanted to continue to vlog and vlog this whole situation. So I didn't vlog my makeup or my hair situation, but this is typically like my usual makeup when I'm going out. But I decided to wear a red lip today. I haven't worn a red lip in so long. So I'm using this YSL Beauty red lip. I'm not sure. Let's see. It's the Slim Velvet Radical lipstick. So this is a lipstick that came in the advent calendar that they sent me last year. So I'm going to do a red lip today. I haven't done a red lip in a very, very, very long time. So let's see how it goes. Ooh. She's cute. I like her. I like it. Okay, I need to make a mental note to get a red lip liner because the only lip liner I have is brown, and I just don't feel okay mixing like a brown lip liner and red lip. But then again, I'm not like a super makeup girly. I could be wrong, but I think I need a red lip liner. But so far, she's cute. I just have a little touch up I need to do on the corners. Make sure I take my compact mirror with me to touch this up and to take a clear lip gloss and a brown liner just in case I want to take this off, because I am that person where I will wipe all this off if I get irritated or I feel like lipstick keeps rubbing against my teeth. But yeah, this is it. Now let's get dressed.
All right, so I'm dressed, ready to go. Let me show you my outfit. So this skirt is from Cezanne. My blazer is from a place that I don't shop at anymore because now I know better, but I bought it from Shein years ago. I've had it for several years. But I thought the blazer went perfect with this skirt because it has a little cutout and a little twisty in the front. My glasses are Burberry. I decided to wear Burberry since I'm going to the Burberry presentation. So that was my sunglass inspo. And then I have my Burberry bag and I did a little scarf tie around. Fun fact, when I bought this bag, I couldn't decide if I wanted black or brown. And the sales associate was like, oh, well, let's just tie a little scarf around it to see how you feel about it. I think you should get black because it's classic. But if you want to pop a color, let's just do the scarf and see how you feel. So she tied the scarf around the bag. And I was like, oh, I love that. She was like, yeah, this will work perfect. So I get to the counter and it was like $400 extra added. And I was like, what's that? She was like, oh, the scarf. The lady upsold me on a scarf. But I was like, you know what? I'm not mad at it, girl. Do you? You did your job. But this is the outfit. I have on a gold heel. I packed some sandals because I don't know what my feet are going to feel like. But yeah, this is the complete outfit of the day.
Watching the show, I think for me this was one of those aha moments in life, and I was like, why have I never thought of this earlier? But I love what he did here with the layering. I would have never thought to layer multiple pairs of shorts. So these are actually two different pairs of shorts. You have more of a classic boxer short underneath, and I love kind of lifting the waistband so you can see it underneath. So give it a little bit more fashion credit. So you have a more of a boxer short that layered on top. You have this really beautiful, again, you have to feel the fabric.
This is going to be in an oversized car coat. And if we think of the trench coat as really iconic to Burberry, the other thing is the car coat for us. Again, something that's really exploded throughout the years. It's been around forever, but in menswear the last 20 years or so, it's really grown in dominance. It's going to be a little bit more oversized with that raglan sleeve, which is perfect for layering, so you can really layer up underneath for extra warmth if you need to. It's got that chain detail print on the outside that we were mentioning before. And what I really love is on the inside, that print continues on the coat in a really nice finishing. So it's not like you have an unfinished look on the inside, which I think adds a lot of quality appeal to this outerwear.
Thank you.
You want to see those on me?
Yes, I do.
Oh, okay.
Absolutely. Why not?
Okay. It's a little different.
It is. But I'm a big fan.
Oh, but I'm not mad.
Yeah.
Okay.
I wouldn't have put them on you if I didn't think they'd be
cool. I'm not mad at you. Huh. Interesting. So, okay.
How do you feel?
I feel good. They're so light. I wasn't expecting them to be like light.
But no.
And the blue?
The lady in the blue. She just purchased these. She was one of the first people to get them. This is the brown tourist. They do have a polarized lens as well.
I like it. Yeah. Usually I'm not a fan of metal frames.
Yeah, why is that?
I have like maybe two.
Okay.
No, I thought they were yellow, but they give more gold when I look at them in the mirror.
Depending on the angle you're looking at it, it kind of gives like a red tint as well.
Huh. Is Ferrari going to be my next shopping like sunglass thing? Like I've never...
That would work for me. So that...
You know, I kind of have a pair like this from Versace. And I'm not too crazy about them, but when they work, they work.
Now, the other color, this one is a little bit more of a red-orange lens, and it has a black frame instead. That could be a different look.
This gives me, like, race car vibes.
Yeah. And when you were saying earlier, are they girly? And I was like, yeah, they're unisex. Depending on,
where. These remind me of, like, you know when people were trying to be innovative during COVID and they were wearing those shields? That's what these remind me of.
The shield is really
good. I don't know if I like the shield. Okay, and then I want to try the silver ones, and I think those are the only ones that really, like, stand out to me. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I'm not mad at these.
Brushes because I have an outbreak right here, and I was like, nope, let me clean my makeup brushes because sadly, unfortunately, embarrassingly, it's been a long time since I washed my makeup brushes, and I need to do that because I really don't get breakouts often. So when I have one, I'm like, oh, it's time to clean my makeup brushes, which is sad. I need to do a better job, but my makeup brush cleaning is really simple. I use Dawn dish detergent. I was using the liquid gel, but since I switched to this power wash, it's been getting the job done. I love that it's like a foam and it's like, I don't know, like you just spray it. But that, like Dawn gets the dirt and the oil out of almost anything. So I use it to clean my makeup brushes. And then I have this little scrub thing that I bought from Amazon that I just rub the brushes up against. I used to use the little bowl that you attach the brush to and let it spin around, but that seems so time consuming. This gets the job done way quicker, and it seems to, like, I don't know, I like the idea that I can like rub the brushes up against something to clean it. So I'm cleaning my makeup brushes. Today is Sunday, it's a rainy day, so today is a cleaning day in general. I love rainy days when I can just turn on some music, light a candle, and just get into my cleaning mode. I'm baking some banana bread today. I'm also making pizza today. So I feel like I'm in my Martha Stewart girl era, but just for one day, just for today. Something about rainy days are just very peaceful for me, and I can get a lot of things done. things just seem like steel. So that's on my agenda today. A bunch of cleaning. And this is probably Alexa telling me what the weather is. Alexa, Alexa, play my notifications.
Yasmin, there's one new notification from Amazon Shopping. There's a low price offer from your sale.
Oh, girl, Alexa, stop. I thought she was about to tell me a weather notification. She's trying to get me to buy something. All right. But yeah, I'm just cleaning today, cleaning the makeup brushes, getting things done, prepping for the week. Y'all, so I'm in World Market, and I thought that I liked Home Goods and TJ Maxx and stuff, but why nobody ever told me about World Market? Like, this place is amazing. They have all the ramen noodles here. I think I'm about to try one. It's just so much going on. I don't know what to choose from. Gonna go with these. Or now, maybe I'll go with these. Y'all, they even have Garrett's popcorn in World Market. This is so crazy to me. Why haven't I ever been in here? Like, if I was making a little goodie basket for somebody, I would definitely buy this and just stuff it with, like, little small stuff. Like, that's so cute. And they have the little mini shopping baskets. So you can stuff it with, like, mini stuff, like popcorn. They have the little sauces over here. So you can do that. This is so cute. So that was my first time in World Market, and I've been missing out on so much stuff. I don't understand why I haven't been in there. Okay, so my purchases from World Market, I got the Garrett's spicy cheesy corn. So when I was in Chicago, I went in September and I got this, and they were like, oh, we only have it during this time of the month. And every time I forget to order it, because you can get it delivered. But they have it in a bag. And I was like, let me check the expiration on this, because this don't even sound right. But the expiration date is July 28, 2024, so we're good. I cannot wait to get into this. And then, I got this candle. It's called Palo Santo. And if you are familiar with Lalabo Santal 33, I think the candle is Santal 26, then this smells just like it for $14.99. And oh, it smells so good. I cannot wait to light it tonight. I have dinner to go to tonight, but when I get home, I'm lighting this bad boy up. But yeah, if you have a World Market near you, I highly suggest go, because they had so... I really wanted like some ramen, but it was just too much to choose from. I was very overwhelmed. So yeah, next time I go back, I'm going to get some ramen. All right, so I am headed to dinner, and this is my dress. I'm so excited because I rarely ever get to wear this dress. Even like last summer, I rarely got to wear it. And I like it because the zipper zips all the way down, and it can zip all the way up. But I want to show a little thigh today. A lot of thigh today. So I'm doing this. I got this from this site called Afeur, I believe. I'll post it below, but I love, love, love this dress. The sleeves can go up or down.
But yeah, this is my outfit, headed to dinner. I'm going to the opening of this new Mexican restaurant in Decatur, which I'm super excited about because the Instagram looks gorgeous. I hope the food is as good as the Instagram looks, so we'll see. Craziest nap. Like, I was so tired. And usually I try to avoid taking naps during the day because I don't sleep well at night. So today, like, my body just didn't have it in me and I had to go lay it down. But hopefully I can sleep tonight because I'm about to go to Soul Cycle. I haven't been to Soul Cycle in so long. And I was like, I need to get my life together. I gotta figure out something. Like, Tuesday, I went on a walk and my Apple Watch said I had walked for like 82 minutes. So I was like, okay, Yasmin, like, you did good, girl. And then today is Wednesday. Oh, so that was yesterday. My days run together. So today is Wednesday and I was like, I'm going to go to Soul Cycle. And then hopefully tomorrow I can make it to the gym. But going to the Soul Cycle because today, I booked today because today is, like, they have themes. I don't know if y'all have ever been to Soul Cycle, but they have themes. They have, sometimes they have, like, Wake and Drake or, like, morning classes. They'll play, like, Drake music. Today's theme is Sierra and Future, which is crazy, but I'm going to the Sierra and Future class today. So that should be a fun class, but yeah, I'm trying to get my life together, y'all. In true Atlanta fashion, I am stuck in traffic. My light is right there, and if this car would move, I can just scoot over. But there's a traffic jam. I'm on Peachtree Road. There's a traffic jam, and traffic is not moving. And I can't. Oh, are we moving? Just a little teeny tiny bit. I have 5 minutes to get to my class. 5 minutes to get to my class, park, change my shoes, and get to Soul Cycle. Oh, we're moving. I made it. Barely. That was refreshing. My hair looked crazy. That means I worked hard.